say your own is here with you. Let's start listening to the first testifier. We are listening to testimonies now of the great things God has done. As we are listening, remember we are still in God's presence and the power of God is still moving. God will touch you and you will come and join them. Once you get your own miracle, come and join. We want to hear your testimony. The first testifier, please.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. God is doing.
Something is happening. Can you hear the shout? Something is happening. God is at work. God is at work. Nobody should move. We are in God's presence. God is distributing presence. Can you hear the shout? Can you hear the shout? More of the shout going on. More of the shout going on. God's power is moving in the car. Jubilation. Joy. Amen. Doctor, go ahead.
My name is Dr. John Dixon. The person by my side is Master Igwe Goodluck. He's here to testify what God has done in his life.
Church, praise the Lord. I'm here to testify what God has done in my life. I am an addicted gambler. I'm Igwe Goodluck by name. I stay at Room 06 lot at Link Road. I'm an addicted gambler. I've played gamble since year 2012 till date. I've played to the extent that on Thursday I was passing for a suicide mission. I left house. I say, let me go and kill myself because of the level I've played gamble. So as I was passing, I saw people entering the gate, through the gate. As I saw people, I was with short knicker. The thing discouraged me not to go. But to pass the gate, something was struggling with me. Say, don't pass, enter. Don't pass, enter. So immediately I enter, and I heard the word of God, like a burden flew from my body. So I have come to give God all the glory. But today, I'm no longer a gambler because...
Can you shout? Praise the Lord! God is here. Everybody say, God is here. Put your hand together for Jesus. My brother, go. You are free. You are free. You are free. You see how God arrested him? Nobody publicized this crusade. God said, enter. 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 Your coming here will not be in vain.
Praise the Lord. What the physician and drugs could not do, Jesus can do. Mrs. Chukwu Francisca is here to tell us how Jesus touched her life. Let's hear her.
Praise the Lord. I really thank God for what the Lord has done in my life. In fact, I'm a living testimony. Last 2 years, I was suffering from insanity, really madness. So my sister directed me to come to GCK. She's from outside. She told me if I come, it could be a spiritual problem that I will be free. As I came to GCK last year, June, I became well. I begin to read my Bible, begin to live a normal life like a normal woman be. I'm no longer living in sin. The Lord has healed me and delivered me. Thank you, Jesus.
Insanity, madness, put your hand together for Jesus. This is night of jubilation. The test testifier, please.
Praise God. The person by my side is Mr. Sine Laziga. He's here to testify of the miraculous touch of Jesus in his life. Let's hear him.
Praise the Lord! My name is Sine Lezongia. My brethren, it has been a long story that we cannot go on to tell all. Over 23 years I've been battling with diabetes. Last Saturday, I even saw the face of God praying, and I came out testimony period. During the testimony period, a sister was sharing her testimony, and she was saying that it came to a point that electric shocks were around her. All her body, she was feeling shocks. And right as she was saying those things, I was feeling the shock of electric on my parts, on my body, and everywhere. And that was how the diabetes were dried off. As I went back, I slept through the night. I only passed urine one time in the morning. I checked the following day, the tune was like that. And even till this morning, God has done it for me. God has taken away my burdens. Join me and worship the Lord and glorify Him.
Praise.
Join Him. Let's worship God. Let's worship God. 23, yeah, diabetes God. Worship God. Worship God. Can you see the sound of the power of God? God is moving in the car. Join and worship God. All power. All power belongs to God. Power of diabetes we bow. Power of sickness we bow. All power belongs to God. Sing and worship God. Get ready, we'll soon come to online.
The next testifier is Mr. Monday Ogo. He's here to tell us what God has done unto him. Let's hear him.
People of God, praise the Lord. Indeed, we serve a God of miracles. It does happen. My name is Reverend Monday Ogo. By the grace of God, I serve in the Divine Yards, and I'm just retired from where I served about 2 years ago. But invitation was given to me by our senior brother who worship here. And by the grace of God, since 1997, I've been a friend of this ministry because of my service in the Divine Yard. I visited here in 1997, and since then I've been a friend. So I was here on Thursday. Why is it there? It's like an arrow was shot to my heart, to my chest. I'm almost passed up there. I was just say, God, what would they say that I came to this place? And while our Father was ministering, I was just saying to myself, Father, this message is mine. Hallelujah. And he said, the woman make up her heart and said, if only I can touch the hems of Jesus Christ, that she will be healed. And I claim that word. Sir, to the glory of God, after the prayer, I was totally healed. My testimony is three, but I'll give the rest. Thank you so much. God bless you.
Together for Jesus. Satan cannot attack anybody here. The arrow of Satan will not get you. Say never. The next testifier, please.
Praise the Lord. The child by my side is by name Justice Barnabas. The mother is here to tell us how Jesus visited him and brought a remarkable change into his life. Let's hear from her.
Brethren, praise the Lord. I'm happy to be here this evening to testify of the goodness of the Lord in this my child. My name is Chioma Barnabas, and I want to testify on behalf of Justice Chibweke Barnabas. I am from Ahoda East Region Hospital Group. God has been so faithful in the life of this child. Right from birth, this child had no anus to defecate, to pass through. You can stay for 3 good weeks, you cannot pass through. They even assigned us to go to China when I've not gotten money to buy ice fish. I say, God, what will I do? They say, go to Radio Rivers, go everywhere and announce. I say, I can't announce. Finally, I said, I believe in God. And I kept believing in God. So when the GCK started, and we always attended, God did the first operation. The anus was opened. Whenever I came back, praise the Lord, whenever I came back and I saw that my child passed two, instead of the smell after 3 weeks, I would be happy. I said, oh, he passed two. We begin to rejoice in the house that he passed two, because it was not easy. A pregnant woman is not different from when he wants to pass through. The one that happens that is making me very, very surprised is he started urinating, frequent urinating from baths. From baths, no stop. We bought Pampers until we were tired. Until he started rejecting Pampers. Every minute he cannot stand like in the school. That he made us, we cannot take him to school. In the church, you carry bags of clothes. You change every time, mopping in the day, in the night, we don't sleep. Until on the November, this GCK of November, then on the 22nd of November, made him 11 years. And when our daddy said the crusade, they were he was going to India, my brethren, I was happy. My heart was filled with joy. I was physically in Nigeria, but I was at India with daddy. I said, if our God can use our father to penetrate through India, God will do something spectacular in the life of this child. And my brethren, that urination, the last day of the GCK, as the GCK finished, that night, we did not even take notice again. Throughout that night, this boy slept. He did not urinate. Till today, he has not been passing that period. God sealed that bladder. We were afraid that the bladder is loose, but we had no money to go for operation. God did the operation, and that is how that frequent urination stopped. And from that very day also, some changes came in his life. He didn't have any feeling. Vehicle can be coming, bicycle, whatever, he just stands there. But from that very day, as soon as he sees vehicle, he will just run away from the road. I say, may the name of the Lord be glorified. Praise the Lord!
Praise the Lord. Justice Barnabas had a condition called Down syndrome. It comes with intellectual and mental retardation. And that was why he could not really understand himself. And then also he's a bit urinary incontinence and all that. There are a lot of abnormality associated with this syndrome. It's as a result of chromosomal abnormality, chromosome 21. But God has touched him. Some of the retardation has been restored. And the rest will believe that it will all be done. Praise the Lord.
Abnormality. See how God created anus and stopped the constant urination. Can you put your hand together for Jesus? The next testifier, please. After this, we go online. Online, get ready, please.
The next testifier is possible. Chamoria, she's here to give a testimony of what God has done for her.
Church, praise the Lord. By the grace of God, I'm Sister Possible Tari Worio. By the grace of God, I'm saved from Igwe Island Group. I want to testify of God's miraculous healing in my life. Truly, I'm the one God has shown mercy. It happened in the year 2021, in the month of March. The very day I was to see my messes, I just sat down. Menstrual pain is a normal thing, but that particular one was more than menstrual pain. All of a sudden, I saw something was just moving in my abdomen. At that very moment, my body changed. My body color changed. I was sweating. I was vomiting at the same time. I was weak at the same time. Everybody was running around for me in the school environment. They asked me, what is the problem? I said, I don't know. That it seems my message is about to come out. But I have not experienced this type of thing before. Thinking it was normal, it will only be for that month. The next month again, it happened in April, it happened in May, and I was confused. I had to go to the hospital, and they said, you're having appendix, you're having fibroid, you're having infection. I said, how come all these things on me? How? I didn't know that. the enemy came in like a flood. But thank God, the Spirit of the Lord lifted up a standard on my behalf. I say, may the name of the Lord be glorified in Jesus' name. How did it happen? I didn't get my miracle. All of a sudden, the GCK came up in the month of June. I even did evacuation because of this problem. In the month of June, the GCK started. Every day, I'll be dropping my prayer request. I will write the prayer request, drop it on the ground, and go. I say, God, I'm leaving this prayer request. I'm leaving this problem here. It didn't happen that day until the Divine Touch Crusade. That Divine Touch, I prayed, I cried. I said, God, I can't be suffering in pain. A small girl like me, I can't be suffering like that. I had a dream. In that dream, Jesus just finished his ministration. And I said, let me go and ease myself in the toilet. When I went to the toilet, instead of urinating, I was urinating blood. Blood. I was surprised. All of a sudden, a stone just came out of my body. And since then, that particular pain has stopped. That particular pain, I'm not feeling it again. Not only that, 2022, the enemy attacked my leg. I couldn't use my leg to walk. Just like the way the sister was testifying yesterday, I couldn't use my leg to walk. I was even crawling. At the time when we went to Chemist, my husband had to carry me on his back to bring me back because I couldn't walk. But when we went to December retreat in that year, 2022, I told God, I said, God, I'm going to retreat. I'm going to serve you. I'm not going to sit down. I'm going to walk. Please, I don't want this pain on my leg. Do you know? From that very first day I went to that retreat, I came back whole and healthy. I say, may the name of the Lord be glorified.
Praise the Lord. Sister Possible had what we call severe dysmenorrhea for 1 year. That is severe pain during the normal menstrual cycle. And it deferred medication, but treatment in the hospital, but Jesus touched her, and that severe dysmenorrhea is gone. Praise the Lord.
Online. This is the night of God's power. We've prayed for it, we've longed for it, and now we behold it. Sicknesses, diseases, and difficulties are bound to the power of prevailing prayers, and destinies are being rewritten. Indeed, Jesus is a miracle worker. We now bring you testimonies of God's wonders from our online community.
From Benin, Nigeria, Godwin Divine is testifying. Thank God for saving me from eye pain and blessing my family. Thank you, Jesus.
And that Jesus should be thanked for everything. Blessing Uosu from Edo State, Nigeria, is thanking God for healing her from severe headache. Hallelujah.
Amen. As healings are being wrought by Jesus the healer, miracles of restoration, deliverance, and salvation are happening. Here's a testimony from Isaac Adedokun from Oshobo, Nigeria. I want to thank God for his mercies and salvation and for the miracle of healing. I was having pains in my stomach area, and after the prayers, the pain wasn't there again. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. This is something about the last amen. Agnes from Southwest Nigeria testifies, I want to praise God Almighty for healing me of stomach pain on Saturday after the last amen. And on Sunday, I could now stand on my feet and jump while singing and praying. Amen.
Amen. From Omoku Rivers, Bro Dixon Okoro was healed from hepatic whitlow in his finger, which lasted for more than 2 years. He was healed after the prayer of the man of God on the first day of this GCK. His wife was also healed of ulcer. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Isaac Adedokun from Oshobo, Nigeria, is thanking God for his mercies and salvation for the miracle of healing. He said, I was having pains in my stomach area, and after the prayers of God's servant, Pastor Dr. W. Kumuyi, the pain wasn't there. Now I'm healed. Glory to God.
Hallelujah. And right now, we bring you this interesting testimony from West Africa, the Gambia precisely. The Gambia broadcasting live.
Praise the Lord. I'm a medical practitioner from the Gambia. We have a striking testimony from one of our sisters here who is going to give her testimony. I hand over to her to give her testimony.
Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. My name is Sister Victoria Olamide Dixon. I'm testifying from Pipeline, Deeper Life Bible Church, Pipeline District, the Gambia. It happened that some weeks back, it has been happening for some time, but I can't even really say when it started. But last week, I've been having the pain, but last week it became very severe that I had to go to the hospital. But when I got to the hospital, the doctor ran some tests with an ultrasound, and he told me it's ovarian cyst. So he prescribed medicines for me. He placed me on drug for a month. And on that, it was on a Friday. On that same Friday, I came to church. We had a program, women program here. I brought the prescription note to our mommy here, the National Overseer's wife, Mommy Oladapo. And she told me that the medicines that the doctor prescribed for me, that they are just painkillers, that I should believe in God, that this GCK is coming, that I should just believe and put it in prayers that God should take the ovarian cyst away. And since then, I've been believing in God. But all of a sudden, that week, I noticed that my stomach started swelling up. I began feeling swelling in my stomach. Well, I didn't know what to do, but I was praying and believing in God. But on Thursday, when the crusade started, God visited me. When I came to the program, even during the program, I had to take my medicine inside the church because I didn't want to go out. The message was going on. I didn't want to miss anything. So I just stayed in the church and took my medicines there. So during the prayer of the man of God, after the prayer, I said, after the last amen, I said amen to all the prayers. Even during the message, I just had my mind in that program for that day that today, God, I want you to heal me from this sickness. And after the prayer of the man of God, when I got home, I discovered that my tummy that was swollen became flat. Everything, all the swelling, everything disappeared. I was happy. Then the following day, I decided to go to the hospital. I went back to the hospital. The doctor said, I've seen your face before. What happened again? I said, well, I came last week Friday. But I just decided to come today that I want to know the progress of the medicines you told me to be taking. I want to know the progress. I want to know what is happening, if there are changes or not. Then he said, okay, that he should check me again. Then when he started checking me, what I heard him say was, this is good, wonderful. Then he started checking. All of a sudden, he just asked me, when did you start taking these medicines I prescribed for you? I said, just last week, Friday. He said, are you sure you came here last week, Friday? I said, yes. Then he asked his assistant nurse again. He said, was this lady here on Friday? The lady said, yes. He said, this is wonderful. You mean under a week, ovarian cyst disappeared? I said, it was last week Friday I came here and you told me it is ovarian cyst I had. And he said, this is wonderful. He just told me, he told the nurse, he said, this lady is very, very lucky. Ovarian cyst disappeared under a week. I say because of this, the name of the Lord be praised forever and ever in Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord. Our ovarian cyst is a condition that can come up in a reproductive woman, and at times the causes may not be known, and at times you see secondarily infected, and that's the reason why she may be having on and off pain. But we thank the Lord during this GCK, according to her testimony, at the prayer of the man of God, the ovarian cyst disappeared. The doctor that made the diagnosis checked her again and could not find it anymore. I pray that her testimony will be permanent in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord.
Mary Davidson from Kumasi, Ghana, testifies, I thank the Lord for healing me from severe pain at the back and fatty liver after the prayer of the man of God.
Hallelujah. Indeed, what God cannot do does not exist. Rose Somerset from United Kingdom, I got healed of severe chest pain. Hallelujah.
Amen. We now return you to the officiating overseer.
Praise the Lord. God is still performing wonders. The person by my side is Miss Comfort Obison. She's here to testify of what God has done for her.
Church, praise the Lord. Indeed, what God cannot do does not exist. My name is Comfort Obison. I live in Wuchi. I've not been feeling fine for the past 4 months. I've been having severe pains on my breast. Anytime I touch the breast, I feel severe pain. Like I feel a very big lump in the breast. So I can't even shake my body. Like I pamper the breast. I wouldn't want to wear bra. Like I have to be very, very careful. And the breast was getting very, very big. So it was when I went to the hospital, one of the doctors that was attending to me is a Deeper Life member. She said, now that you're complaining about this thing at this age, we are having a program. I promise you that when you come to this program, you're definitely going to have your healing. Just come with an open heart. So on the second day of the program, that was on Friday, I came. As the man of God was ministering, I just opened my heart. I said, God, have mercy upon me. I don't know where this is coming from, but I don't want to leave this program with this sickness. So I prayed that prayer after he declared cancer at any stage disappear. What from any form of affliction, I command it to disappear. So I just key into it. When I went back, I was feeling somehow light in my body. I said, what is really going on? Okay, God, if this is really you, when I wake up tomorrow morning, I don't want to feel anything at all. So when I woke up the next morning, it was as if something left my body. I touched my breast. I was not feeling any part of it. I made sure I pressed the breast very well. I could not feel no single pain, no single love, nothing, everything disappeared. So I'm here to give all glory to God. I say, may God alone be, may his name alone be praised in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Miss Comfort Obisio has left suspicious left breast mass associated with pain. But as she came to this program, after the prayer of the man of God, the lump and the pain disappeared. Praise God.
Everybody say disappear. Every problem in your life will. The next testifier.
The next testifier is Mrs. Bright Nana. She's here to share with us the miraculous work of God. Let's hear her.
Praise the Lord. Praise the living God. My name is Mrs. Bright Nana. By the grace of God, I am saved. I'm in Port Harcourt region, River State, Nigeria. My testimony is on divine deliverance. The Bible said in Obadiah chapter 1, verse 17, said upon Mount Zion there shall be deliverance. And I came here last year, June, by the grace of God. God delivered me from strange voices. Initially, what happened was, when I go to evangelism, I come back, I don't hear those voices. But whenever I don't go out for evangelism, It's as if the enemy wants to mess up with the gift of God in my life. Because God gave me a gift and I hear his voice audibly. So the enemy tried to mesmerize with that. But to the glory of God, June last year, the last day of the program, I came here because I was actually bitter. I can't just communicate with people because when they are talking, there are voices I hear behind the voice. When I came, I was praying. One of the men came, he said, leave this altar. Tears came out from my eyes. I said, let me explain. He said, no. I said, leave here. As God may help me, the next morning, I came back to this same altar. After praying, I was led to go to the GSC. Immediately, I touched that seat. A cold sensation from the crown of my head went down to the sole of my feet. And since that day, God delivered me from that strange voice. And God helped me to achieve so many things within some few periods. I just want to glorify God, because the God that did it for me will actually do it for you in Jesus' name.
Strange voices disappear. Tonight is your night. The next testifier, please.
The next testifier is Miss Geoffrey Doherty.
My name is Geoffrey Doherty. I want to thank God for my life and the life of my fellow choristers. This was on the 9th of February. We came for rehearsal. Then on Saturday morning, we were back going. So going to the first one, like going back home, Asiana was having a U-turn, so our taxi where we're in was just driving straight ahead of it. All of a sudden, the Asiana turned again in the middle of the road, and the taxi where we're in, the driver just drove and ran into the front of the Asiana, and then the Asiana and the taxi were just moving like that. So we sighted Jesus twice, and then the car stopped. Then the glass cracked. Then the Sienna blocked the front seat, the right where I and a friend of mine were seated. So the car started bringing out smoke. So the driver had to leave from his driving seat. And I and my friends came out from the driving seat. The others came out from the back. So I want to thank God for his guidance and protection upon our life and saving us from a car accident. Praise the Lord.
Put your hand together for Jesus. Testifier, after this we go online. Don't go online, please get ready.
Praise the Lord. The Lord is still at work. The next person by my side is Miss Winwa Precious. She's here to tell us what God has done for her.
Praise the Lord. I want to thank God for his healing power upon my life. January this year, I started noticing weakness inside my body. Like even when I've not done anything, I start to feel weak and as if I want to faint or suffocate. But I want to thank God. Yesterday night, when I laid one of my hand on my heart region and raised one hand up, and God delivered me by the grace of God. No more weakness inside. God has strengthened me. Praise the Lord.
Clap for Jesus. No more weakness. We now go online.
Welcome back. We have more amazing testimonies for you. This is from Salvation Angie. Salvation is thanking God for healing. She wrote, I've been having chest pain, but at the last amen, I have been healed of chest pain. Praise the Lord. I am okay in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen. Upon Mount Zion, there is indeed deliverance. Kingsley Wabara from Rivers, Nigeria wrote, I want to thank God for healing me. I developed pneumonia August 2021, and since then, I've been having difficulty in breathing. But after the GS prayer this night, I received my healing. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Of a truth, there is no impossibility with the power of prevailing prayer. Brother Ogene Ro Efemwari from Warri Region, Delta State, Nigeria. Delta State, Nigeria, broadcasting live.
For how God visited me in the last Global Crusade, that is the January edition of the Global Crusade 2024. It all happens, I was having this problem with my navel. My navel sometimes bring out pulse and a very nasty smell. And this thing has persisted for a very long time, but I've not really taking it out for any medical treatment. Even at the time, I told one of her sisters, who is a nurse, and she did not really give me any answer about it. But at the time, the thing was becoming unbearable. In fact, that January, it was now smelling a kind of all around me, and the smell used to be very irritating. So during the Global Crusade, I decided to be laying my hands on it. Anytime the GS is praying, I will lay my hands on it. It was after the Global Crusade, all the smell and the pulse, everything just disappeared. And from that time till now, I never had that experience. Praise the Lord. My name is Ogenero Ifemwari from Ogunu Group of Districts, Warri Region, Delta State, Nigeria. Amen.
What an awesome Jesus! Disappearances of sicknesses and diseases. And now, we'll bring you this testimony from DCLM YouTube, Zeribi Favor Joy from Osun State, Nigeria. She said, I have just been healed of my broken knee. I had an accident last week, Monday. I am healed. I have been jumping. Thank you, Jesus.
We now bring you a testimony from Southeast Nigeria, Abia State, broadcasting live.
Yeah. I am Dr. Nwachukwu Martha. I'm a consultant anesthetist and critical care physician, giving this testimony from Deeper Life Bible Church, Umuahia, Abia State 1, Nigeria. I'm here to testify of the mighty deliverance of God, delivering my niece from death. And my niece is here, Virtue Mesomachukwu Collins, who was very sick in the year 2023. The illness started in December 2022, when she was unwell, and she was taken to a nurse who gave her some injections, and later she was taken to a rehabilitation where the injections given to her led to a complication called neuroleptic malignant syndrome. And that manifested as very high temperature, muscle rigidity, mental alteration, and autonomic dysfunction. And thereafter she became unconscious and had to be evacuated to National Hospital Abuja to be managed in the intensive care unit. There in the intensive care unit, she went through all stages of ICU care, from mechanical ventilation to tracheostomy, to the point that her care became stagnant because she wasn't improving. But during February GCK, Abundant Life Through Christ, during the prayers, she was connected to the prayers. After the prayers of the man of God, her condition improved miraculously. Within 1 week, she was discharged out of the intensive care unit. Praise the Lord. And here she is to give a testimony of God's deliverance in her life.
Praise.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I'm a biochem student of Federal University of Lafayette, Anambra State. During the Christmas holiday 2022, I fell sick and my parents consulted a nurse to come and treat me at home. After the treatment, I resulted to going to rehabilitation center at Lafayette, at Agerago, Lafayette, Anambra State. From the rehabilitation center, I landed in ICU. After the ICU, during the February GCK prayer, the phone was placed on my ear. My family members were shouting amen to my hearing. And after the prayer, after a week, there was a great improvement. I was discharged into the ENT ward. From the ENT ward, I was discharged home and I could go back to school successfully. I want to thank God for keeping me alive. I want to thank God for giving me the grace to stand before His presence and testify about His goodness. Praise the Lord.
Glory to God for these testimonies. Gideon Dua believes in miracle, and he got one tonight. He wrote, "I am healed from waist and hips pains. Thank you, God." Right now, we hand over to the moderating overseer.
Praise the Lord. The person by my side is Mr. Insei Ikannem. He's here to testify of how God delivered him. Let's hear from him.
Okay. Praise the Lord. My brothers and sisters, my name is Insei Ikannem. I was suffering from cobweb for about 20 something years. So this thing, it happens that when I stay in the house, the thing will hang me all over my body, my face. It will hang me on my way, walking on the way, it will hang me. You can see me, one will see me rubbing my face all the time when I'm walking on the way, cleaning the cobweb. So this thing continued for a long time. So during last year, GCK, the title was "Lose Him and Let Him Go." So I came for that crusade. I believe God that the Lord would do something about it. As I came, I prayed to God, and I believe God. As a man of God came, our Father in the Lord, he came and prayed. During the last amen, I believe that the Lord has done it. So up till now, from that time, I don't experience such thing anymore. I say may his name be glorified in Jesus' name. Amen. And the second one is that I was having terrible dreams. The enemies will be fighting me in the dream. So as I come for this program, I say, "Lord, do something about it and help me to prevail over all the enemies." So I come for this program, day one, day two, day three, and this today, there's no such thing anymore. By the grace of God, I've prevailed over all the enemies in Jesus' name.
Go and prevail, amen. My brother. You are prevailed. Put your hand together for Jesus.
Praise the Lord. The healing power of God is still moving around in the camp. The person by my side is Mrs. Enoima Basi Progress. She's here to share of how the Lord healed her. Let's hear from her.
Praise the Lord. I'm by name Enoima Basi Progress. I'm here to share this testimony to the glory of God. For about 4 months, I've been having pains in my ears. And whenever this pain comes, it comes with headache. If I put anything, even earbuds, to clean my ears, the pains trigger. And I've asked people, they say it's like there's a boil in my ear, which we've checked, there is no boil. Yesterday, while Pastor came up, he said, turn to your neighbor, and he made mention of something. I turned around, I just said it to somebody, and I asked myself, will you come and go back the same? Don't you have any issue, any concern in your life? And I remembered the ear, and I said, God, take care of this ear. After the prayer, I went back to the hostel. I forgot about it. Only this morning, I decided to touch the ear. I did not feel anything, because on Friday, when I was here, the pains came again, and it came with severe headache. Even my neck was swollen. My sibling was the one that asked me, what happened to your neck? I said, it's the pain in my ears. But as I'm talking to you today, right now, I have touched the ear. I put something in the ear. There's no sign of pain again. I've just come to return all this glory to God. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. In our email, Basi Progress had what we call otitis media externa for 4 months. And after the prayer of the man of God, that problem was healed. The pain in the external part of the ear is gone. Praise the Lord. The next person by my side is Mrs. Maxwell Marion. She's here to testify that distance is not a barrier to the miraculous power of God. Let's hear her.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. My name is Sister Marion Maxwell. I'm from Mbano Estate Group in Fortune Local Government, Oyibo Region, River State. Praise the Lord. I come to return all the glory to God who delivered my mother last year during the Supernatural Crusade of June edition in this place. Praise the Lord. It happened that before the crusade, my mother was sick, very sick, and they were calling her to come home to carry her to the hospital. She said that she was not going, that she believed that God will heal her. She could not go to toilet for 2 weeks, and the thing became a problem. Calls were coming here and there, and I told them that I was going to crusade, and I came here for the crusade. On Saturday, 24 June, my mother passed on, and she was unconscious from morning till night. So as the call was coming, I told my younger sister that I am going to connect them during the GS prayer, which I did. So after the prayer, I said I will not call them because the call was distracting me. So at the time, Satan began to minister to me, do you think that God has answered your prayer? Do you think that your mother will come back to life? So at the time, I said no, that I've been hearing testimonies, I've been seeing it with my eyes, that my own will not be a difference. Praise the Lord. So on Sunday, I did not call them. So after service, I called my sister. She said, I should praise God that God has done it. And the devil wanted to strike again. Before you know that Sunday evening, the thing happened again. But I believe God strongly that nothing will happen. Praise the Lord. So even in that state, my mother began to pull. She began to defecate until she opened her eyes. And that was how God healed our GS to deliver her, to bring her back to life. Right in Andoni. Praise the living God. My second testimony was about myself. That was 2023. I was so sick when I went for a test. They said I had cardiovascular resistance. I had BP. My BP was increasing every day. And I have ulcer, peptic ulcer and gastric ulcer. I said, only me, all these things. I could not stand for a long time. When we go for practice, after practice, when I come back home, I will just lie down on my bed helplessly. Praise the Lord. But I managed to go to the crusade that was at Bori. When they said everybody should stand up, I was stood. After some seconds, I was sat down. That was how I was just managing myself. So to cut the story short, today, because they said I will die, and I will be hearing voice, I will be finding it difficult to breathe. I'll be hearing words that I will die, but today, God has heals our dears, so bring me back to life. All those sicknesses that they've mentioned, nothing is in my body again. So that I can breathe freely. My BP is normal. I do not buy medicine for one day to drink for BP. God has healed me. I said, God, who has done all this thing for me? May his name be highly exalted in Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord. Mrs. Maxwell Marion testified of how God healed her mother of chronic constipation as a result of intestinal obstruction. After connecting to the man of God prayers, the constipation was resolved and intestinal obstruction resolved. Praise God. For herself, she had a very complicated cardiovascular problem, as you've heard her say. But after the prayer of the man of God, she has been healed. Praise God. The next person by my side who is here to testify to the glory of God is Miss Ike Faith. Let's hear her testimony.
Church, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. My name is Sister Ike Faith. By the grace of God, I'm saved, and I'm from Town Old Group. I want to testify what the Lord has done for me. I've been having this challenge of cold in my body, like I will not be able to stay very comfortably where people are. I will always be uncomfortable and just like that. And most times when we come to this GCK and retreat, I will not be able to bathe in the morning, like, because I will not be able to, but the cold will be so much on me and I'll be uncomfortable. But this GCK, from Friday, since Friday morning, I was surprised. I went to the bathroom and I was like, let me just go and wash my leg. But I just saw myself bathing and I was like, Jesus, me, for over many years, even far back from 2019, I will come to retreat. Maybe I'll just bathe maybe once in the retreat and I'll not be able to bathe because of the challenge. But God healed me and I was just surprised that even yesterday I was like, you have to go and share this testimony. And I say that today I'm going to share the testimony. I just want to thank God for all you have done in my life. And I say, may the name of the Lord be praised in Jesus' name. My testimony is that I was having issues with my prayer life for some time. But on Tuesday, I came for the Tuesday's key leaders meeting. And during when the pastor was leading the prayers, as I followed and I prayed, before you know, my prayer life just stepped up and I just saw myself praying. I have just come to like return the glory to God for all you have done in my life in Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord. Miss Ike Faith testified how God healed her of cold intolerance. You have heard she's having excessive cold to the extent that in the morning she could not have a bed. But God has touched her, that hormonal problem has been taken care of. Praise God.
Praise the Lord. If you are happy, can I hear you? Hallelujah. I say, praise the Lord. We'll rise up and praise God. Jesus said, we'll praise God before the problem, when God take care of the problem, and at the end, we'll still praise God. Now we'll rise up and worship God and praise God for the way he visited us. Look at what God did today. Just give God the glory as we join the choristers to praise God. Thank you. just open your mouth and worship this awesome God. Look at what he did today. Give him the glory. Give him the praise. Give him the adoration for what he did. The Lord honored his name today. Father, we thank you. We worship you. We adore your name for the manifestation of your power and presence in our midst. Thank you for the way you took care of the weather. Lord, we say, may your name be glorified in Jesus' name. Worship you for those you saved, those you healed, those you delivered, those you set free. And Lord, we pray that these miracles be permanent in Jesus' name. We thank you for our Father in the Lord, the convener of GCK, the way you are using him to bring joy, gladness, succor to your children. Lord God, renew his strength. And his labor will not be in vain in Jesus' name. We pray for everybody that you used in one way or the other to make this program impressive and successful. Lord, reward them abundantly in Jesus' name. As we go to rest, Lord God, we pray that your power will still touch us. We'll still remain in your presence. And your blessings will overshadow us. We worship you because you've answered our prayers. For in Jesus' holy name, we are prayed. Let me hear the amen of those who are happy. If you are the happiest person, give the loudest amen.
Were created. Here we see the submission of the saints in heaven and the adoration of the King of Glory. So wherever you are now, you lift up your voice and you give glory to the Lord God of heaven and earth, the Alpha and the Omega, the creator of the universe, the owner of the souls of men, the one who has made it possible for you to be here this very hour, the one who has given you ears to hear, giving you eyes to see, and giving you hope in the land of the living, the one who sent his only begotten son, Jesus Christ, to be a propitiation for the sin of all of humanity, the one that has made it possible for us to call upon the name of the Lord. Let's give glory to the Lord. Give glory to the Lord God of heaven and the earth, the Alpha and the Omega, the Almighty God, the King of the universe, the Ancient of Days. Please let heaven hear your voice as you worship him. Because he demands it, he desires it, and he deserves worship. He deserves your worship. You enter into his courts with thanksgiving and praise, and you worship him because he is the one that is worthy of our worship. Give him glory. Give him praise. Give him adoration. Bow before him. Bring every one of your accomplishments before him. They cast their crowns before him. They cast their achievements before him. They cast all of their positions before him. Before him, everything bows. And if everything is going to bow, we here are going to bow. If the things that pursue you are going to bow before him, you must, first of all, bow before him. So bow before him that sits upon the throne, and he that lives forever and ever, because he is God, and besides him, there is none other. In Jesus' name we pray. Your voice can be louder than that. In Jesus' name we pray. We have to magnify the Lamb that was slain and lives to reign. The one that came and laid his all for the unworthy and bled until there was no more blood and water came out of his sides, so that we that were afar off can be brought unto the Lord God of heaven and earth. Lift up your voice and worship the Lord Jesus Christ, the author of life, the one that has closed the gap between humanity and divinity, the express image of the Most High God. Please worship the King of kings and the Lord of lords, the Lord Jesus Christ, your Savior, your sanctifier, the coming King. Give him glory because he deserves glory. Thank him who set aside all the glory of heaven and came and walked on the earth, died on the cross, suffered untold pains so that we would be free from the pangs of death and the consequences of transgression. Give glory to him. Please open your mouth and say, Lord Jesus, I adore you, I worship you, I magnify you, because you are the source of my life. You are the source of my breath. You are the one that opened the gate that I can mention the name of the Lord, even the Lord God. You are the one that caused my voice to be heard in the courts of heaven. I that wasn't anything that God would have looked at. God would not have looked at our direction, but the Savior came and brought us closer to him by paying the price for our reconciliation to the Most High God. Give him glory. He deserves all the glory. And please let your voice be heard. Let your voice be heard. In Jesus' name we pray. And when the Savior, the Lord Jesus, finished his ministry on the earth, he handed everything to the Spirit of truth. And he said he is going to be with us. He's going to be with the church forever and ever. Open your mouth and worship the Spirit of the living God, the Holy Spirit, the teacher, the comforter, the one that convicts the sinner, the Spirit of life. Worship him. Say, Lord Holy Spirit, I thank you. I thank you for giving me life. I thank you for your companionship of the church. I thank you for interpreting the truth to your church. I thank you for comforting in times of distress. I thank you for your presence in this place and your presence forever until Christ returns. Give him glory. Please give him glory. The Spirit of truth, the executor of the divine will, the one that executes the policeman of heaven, the one that executes the will of the Father on the earth. Give him glory. He is in this place. He is in this place. He is here for you. He is here for his church. He is here because of you. He is here because of me. He is here because of the people that are afar off. And he is in the earth to execute the will of the Most High God. Give him praise. Give him worship. In Jesus' name we pray. That's a bigger amen than that. Psalm 107 verse 15 and 16 says, oh, that men would praise the Lord for his goodness and for his wonderful works for the children of men. For he has broken the yokes of brass and set the bars of iron in sunder. It is time to praise the Lord for GCK, the instrument by which God is reaching the nations 6 days in every month. and 12 months a year. Meaning what? 6 days a month times 12 months a year, 72 days out of 365 days. One out of every 5 days, heaven touches the earth through GCK. Can you please raise up your hand and say, God, I thank you for GCK. What that has made it possible for us to be here. Lord, I thank you for the vision you gave to your servant. I thank you for your faithfulness to this vision. I thank you, Lord, because you've made impossibilities possible. I thank you, Lord, for the technical crew, people who have laid their lives down, put their strength and their talent and their everything on the line for the Lord, that the whole earth would hear the Lord. Thank you, Lord, for those who have made their energy available to do physical work, those who have made their resources available to sponsor the gospel, those who have made their energy available to pray and to fast and to preach and to evangelize and to follow up and to work day and night, that this vision would come to fruition. Please lift up your voices and thank the Lord for Global Crusade with Kumuyi, God's vehicle for global evangelization, God's instrument for the illumination of the earth with the light of the kingdom of God in our time. Thank the Lord for this opportunity. Thank the Lord for this glorious opportunity. We are gathered here. People are gathered in America. People are gathered in England. People are gathered in all continents at the same time, listening to the same message, listening to the same Christ, and getting the touch of the living God. Souls have been saved. Miracles, numberless miracles God has performed at various times. Please open your mouth and say, God, I thank you for GCK. I magnify your name. Thank you for the vision you gave. Thank you, Lord, for your presence. Thank you for your help. I am a witness that God sends down help anytime there is GCK and makes things that have been thought inconceivable to come to materialization. And that is why you are here also, to have a taste of what people would have thought to be impossible. And this night, you will be surprised. People will be surprised at what God will do in your own life. That is why you should thank him for what he has been doing. Thank him for what he has been doing. Thank him for what he will do this night through this program. And thank the Lord for the convener of GCK, God's microphone for this generation. Pastor Dr. W.F. Kumuyi, the man who at his age, the Lord has strengthened. And every month he is moving from one part of the earth to the other, from one part of the nation to the other, preaching morning and preaching evening.